हेलो, आई एम सुनील गुलेरिया एंड टुडे आई वांट टू डिस्कस विद यू दैट इज़ हाउ वी कैन रन पाइथन कोड सर्वर साइड. टू रन द पाइथन कोड सर्वर साइड एंड फॉर दैट वी नीड टू डाउनलोड सम सॉफ्टवेयर एंड वी नीड टू डू सम सेटिंग्स इनटू दोज सॉफ्टवेयर्स. बट today I want to discuss with you that is if you want to run the Python code. So I am going to make this video for Windows 10, and Windows 10 would be better for you if you want to run this code, because for Windows 7 you may require some little bit more changes to do in the softwares. So if you are technical and you have done any server-side scripting code, so then it would be quite easy for you, because you would be familiar with some server-side technologies. But now, according to me, if suppose you have some little bit of experience of programming language, so then you can copy this code. And I'm not going to explain the technologies and the concept behind this, because I just want to record that is how we can write the first Python server side script by using, actually it is actually by using CGI technology. So what I have to do very first, because if you want to run any server side scripting language, for that you need one web server you need to download into your machine. So for that you can go to the web browsers, and then you can type and you have to download that the XAMPP, because it is over here. You can use here XAMPP, and you have to study about this XAMPP little bit, because you have to download this. Now you can go for this, that is Apache friends, because this is actually XAMPP from Apache XAMPP server. So you will go for the download page, and from here you can download, that is the Windows version, and that is Windows 64, because it runs on Windows. Then you have to download this, and you have to follow some of the instructions while it is stored in your machine, that is Windows 10. And after installing, because I have installed this, so after installing, what you have to do, you have to go to your Windows Explorer, and then you can go to check whether it is installed, because you need to install this in C drive generally, and I have installed that in C drive. And then you will find one folder or the directory. You will double click on this, and then search for htdocs. This is your htdocs, is the folder where you have to put your files, or suppose your website, or your suppose all the server side script and code. And over here you can create your own folder, because like I have created, this is, that is my hyphen python hyphen work. This is actually the folder, and you can create one folder of your choice in which you have to store your server side files, or you have to create your project work or coding work. So double click on this, and as we know that XAMPP is the web server which can be used to test your PHP as server side code, as well as this is my one file I have created, that is a Python file as server side script. So now what I have to do, because you have to follow these instructions, I hope you can try to create suppose up to here, that is the folders and all, but you don't need to create these two files. I'll tell you that is how to create and when to create these two files. But just you reach over here, that is you create one your folder into this htdocs folder. Now after this, what do you have to do? This is your first step, that is download XAMPP and check and create one folder into the htdocs. After that, now the next is what? That is you have to run your XAMPP. So when suppose your XAMPP is there, so you can click on this, you can find and search, and you can run this, because you will get here XAMPP, that is control panel. So when, if you will click on that control panel, this is actually the window of XAMPP control panel, and here we have Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury and Tomcat. So here Apache is actually the software which we need, and this is your server, and this is the server who will be responsible to compile and run your suppose your Python code, or your even PHP code or server side script. So what do you have to do? You have to start your server. So you will click on start, and when it seems green over here, it means and then your server is started now. And this is not enough because if you will start this and you will minimize now this and your server is now active. So now what you have to do next, you have to create one file that is .py file. So I can use here Notepad++ as suppose my Python code editor. So you can use any editor, but Notepad++ is open source and free, so you can use it. And now when I'll open this, I'll go for the file very first and I have to save it. Now where you want to save the file, so you have to keep in mind, you have to go for C, you have to go for XAMPP, and then you have to go for htdocs, and you can use your folder. That is, in my case, this is my Python work. I will double click on this and I'll create here, that is one file. I can use here, that is the name of the file, that is my demo. And you can say demo.py, because .py is the extension, as you know very well, because you must know the little bit basics of the Python code. So then you can use .py is the extension, and then you have to save it. And then I have to write my first code over here. So now when suppose you will ask the server to run your code, so then you have to specify that is the interpreter of the Python. So now you have to because if you want to run this, so no doubt your Python should be installed in your machine. And I want to share with you, that is, where is my Python installed in my machine. I'll go for again C drive, and that my Python is installed over here, and this is Python 3.9.0. so this is your Python 3.9, because I have installed it over here. And when you install the Python 3.9 or any Python version, so you have to check that where is your Python installed, and then you have to go to that folder. And within that folder, because it may vary in your machine, but you have to find for the python.exe. This is actually the file that is python.exe, and this is known as your Python interpreter, because when you want to run the code, so then you need to specify the Python interpreter which can be used to run your Python code and Python file. So this is actually my path of the Python interpreters. I'll copy this, and then what I need to do, very first line, you have to just copy this. You have to use let's suppose hash and then exclamation, and then you have to paste it over here. But this is actually the folder where suppose the Python interpreter is existing. You have to mention that is the Python interpreter, because we are writing on Windows, so we have to include that is python.exe. And this is the file, and this is actually Python interpreter. Now after this, this is important, because when your file is requested from the server, so it will use your Python interpreter to interpret the code which you will write in suppose this file further. Next, you have to just copy, and you have to write this, that is the print, because you need to specify, because if you are a little bit familiar with the HTTP header, so you can understand it. Otherwise, you have to copy this. You should use suppose double quotes, and then this is the print function. You know, in Python we have one print function that is used to print something on the screen and on output window. I have to use here, I have to specify that is the content type. Content, you can specify type, and then colon, and then we know that here we have to specify the content type. So that must be, you need to set that is the text, as well as you can use suppose one forward slash, and you can specify either text as well as HTML. You may have noticed that in suppose while you specify your CSS file, so you need to specify the type of the content which you want to display on this page. So we are going to display here text as well as HTML. And here we have two more, suppose you can use here slash r slash n, and you can use it two times, let's suppose slash r and slash n. At this moment we should not ask this, that is why we are going to use it, but in later on we'll discuss about this. You just copy, because you have to run the Python code on server side. So this is actually the setting which you want to say headers you want to set. Now after this, what we want to do, after this we want to, because this is actually a simple code which we want to print here, so you can use here the print function, and then print, and then double quotes. And in suppose this function, what you want to say, you want to use, suppose that is the h1, because h1 you can use here, welcome you in Python server side. This is, you can write like this. And if you want to check whether this Python is being executed, so you can create here one that is num1 is equal to 10, and then you are creating num2 is equal to 20, and then res is equal to num1 and plus num2. What I did over here, that is, I'm going to create two variables and I'm going to add those two variables and putting the result into the res. So now what I have to do, I have to, because we have to understand that is how your client and server interacts with each other, and then the Python code is executed on server side as well as the rest of your HTML code is as it is sent to the client. So what I am going to say here, that is, I'll use here h1, then I will use here plus, and then you must know that I have to use here, that is the res, and with this, what now what I have to do, I have to display this on your HTML page. So I'll close this h1 tag over here. You need to understand, because this is not absolutely for the beginners, so you must be having little bit knowledge of that is how to use HTML and all to use this code. Now what I want to prove here, that is, you are using the very simple way, that is, you are using the Python code over here. And no doubt, when suppose you will come to display the output on the client side, so you must know that how to embed suppose your HTML code, because this is your CGI code. So now what we have to do, now we have to save it, and we have saved this file. And if we'll try to run this file, so now is it possible to run this file? So one more setting we have to do, you have to open your that is XAMPP server control panel, and then you have to open this config file. This is the configuration file for the Apache server. And then what do you have to do? You have to go for Apache and then httpd and .config file. Open this file, and you have to say, keep your cursor somewhere in the beginning, and then you press Control F. And then this is, I have done this earlier. So you just type here add handler, because I have to find for add handler. So click on find next, and you will see here that is add handler you have to, because now what is the role of this config file? It is actually the setting file for your this Apache server. Now by default you will see, and this is actually the line which is very important. You need to set something over here. And when suppose you will open this in Windows 10, so it would be up to here, that is up to .asp. Because now here what we are going to mention, we are going to mention here that is what kind of extensions or what kind of files will be executed by using this Apache server. .cgi, we have pl.asp, and then .py is added by me. It would be like this when suppose you will open this. So what you have to do, you have to add .py over here, because what we are expecting from our Apache server, that is, we want to execute the .py extension file. So now add this, and then what do you have to do? You have to say Control S, that is, you are going to save this file. You can close this as well as you can close this also. And I have established suppose a connection, and I have made changes earlier before starting the Apache server. But if you will make changes after starting the Apache, so then you have to stop it. And when you will stop it, it will, because your Apache server will be stopped, and you have to restart this. So just I am going to stop this, and then when suppose it is stopped, then you have to start it once again. And I have started this once again. Now it is being started once again. So your that configuration settings will be resumed. And now what I have to do next, now if everything is going smoothly, so then we'll try to run our code also. We have written this code. And now what we have to do, we have to open the web browser. And in web browser, you go for the new tab, and then you try to type here, that is localhost. And remember one thing, when you will type this localhost, you will enter suppose if you will enter this. Otherwise, you have to go forward, that is localhost, then forward slash. And in localhost forward slash, you have to go for your, because it goes to the HT docs by default. You have to type here your folder. And that folder was what? That is my, because that depends upon you. This is my folder. And what I have to run over here, that is what you can do. You can press enter over here. It will list the content of that directory. And now from here, I have to try to run this file, that is demo.py. And if everything is fine, so then it will be executed properly. You will click on this. And you can see here, that is the welcome you in Python server side. Whereas the 30 is actually the value of RES, which we have calculated by using the Python code. So this is how we can run the very simple code by using, because you can see here, that is your, this demo.py is executed by the server, that is the local host. So this is how we can write the first code. And thanks for watching, and keep, suppose if you are not clear with this concept, so you need to set your all these things. So keep watching this again and again, and you can take some help from the other videos also. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.